Can I share with you something? I am kind of tired of some of the camps that women take when they are raising their kids. And here is what happens. We want to do right by our kids. We want to raise great families. And so we make these decisions for our families, and you know, we probably pray about it, and we probably get a conviction, and we probably do research and all this stuff, and we make decisions all the time for our families. And those decisions, then we often feel like we have to justify our point of view with whatever it is, whether it's I feel like I am called to be a stay-at-home mom, or I feel like I'm called to be a working mom. And we feel like those things are like do or die camps that we kind of like, you know, we create these mountains and we sort of die on these mountains. I'm not gonna do that. I don't like doing that, because what I believe is that there's probably truth in both sides of the camp. It's not a one or the other. I think there's principles that can guide us, and I think that there is this thing that I wanna talk to you about today called wisdom. Wisdom, 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 wisdom. We need wisdom. Wisdom is not a you should do this or you should do this. Usually in wisdom, there's actually tension, like a rubber band. There's two sides. But what we need is we need wisdom. We need to be able to take and distill down what God is saying about a situation, and we need to be able to apply it in our given context. And so it may be that for one woman, it is exactly the right thing to be a working mom. It may be for one woman that she is fighting to like kind of out of a need to for her own kind of selfish ambition to be a working mom. It may be that she really needs to stay home and she really needs to learn about just being home. It may be for one woman that she needs to homeschool. It may be for another woman that she needs to send her kids to public school. I don't think that there's any one right answer. What I think is that it's the Holy Spirit who's leading us and guiding us, and we're so reliant on the Holy Spirit. We need wisdom. So one piece of wisdom that I want to give you is that God values who we are above what we do. And so, you know what? That's hard. That's a hard one in our culture. That's a hard one to swallow. That's a hard pill to swallow, because we get so much attention for what we do. So if you're like a beast at, you know, marketing or something, you're gonna get a lot of attention for marketing. And then if you, you know, if you end up having kids or whatever, and you feel like, okay, I'm supposed to stay at home, you're gonna have withdrawals from the attention that you got in the marketing world, because you may not get that kind of attention. You probably won't. Let me just tell you, you probably won't get that kind of attention when you're at home. But we are not, our value is not based on what we do. Our value is based on who we are, and more importantly, whose we are. And if we can get that truth from our head, sometimes we know that truth in our head, but we don't know it in our heart. If we can get it from our head to our heart, it will solidify us in our decision-making process, that our value does not come from what we do, it comes from whose we are. Our significance could never be more than what Jesus Christ has given us when he went to the cross for us. There is no other thing that could say, hey, you are significant. There's no boss, there's no parent even that could say you are significant like what Jesus did for us on the cross, each as individuals and corporately. So our value, I mean, this is like throughout scripture, right? I mean, this is a big scriptural theme, is that our value, human value, does not come from what we do. It does not come from how many bricks we can make for Pharaoh. It comes from the living God putting a mark of value, saying you are made in my image, and saying that you're so valuable that I died for you. That's where our value comes from. So now if you as women can take that from your head to your heart and distill it down and really believe that, that is wisdom. That will help you with your decision-making process, so that you're not tethered to Pharaoh, more or less, You're not tethered to those that are telling you, giving you approval, giving you affirmation. You're not tethered to them. You're free. You're free to be able to make choices based on what the Holy Spirit is leading you to do. So I hope that helps.